All right, so everybody's on Realtor time. I know we got about 300 more people still to come, so let's give it another 2 minutes and then we'll get started.
You can dance real quick. We'll have a quick dance party. Yeah. Everybody move or you sit down for a couple hours.
One more song, Dana, and then we'll start.
All right, I'll make it a good one. A lot of pressure. Good choice, Dana. Think about it. There must be a higher love down in the heart or hidden in the stars above. Without it, life is a wasted time. Look inside your heart and I look inside mine. Things look so bad everywhere. In this whole world, what is fair? We walk the line and try to see.
It's okay. I think that we're about ready to maybe get going here. We got still a few more people popping in, but we want to make sure that we honor everybody's time. So let's just kind of get started with some of the pre-work stuff. So let's share my screen here real quick, and then we'll hop into it. All right. Kimberly, see my screen okay?
I got it. Yeah.
Awesome. All right, so we're just going to get started. Welcome to the 2020 Business Planning Clinic. My name is John Morris. I'm the Regional Growth and Technology Director for the Maryland DC region. And we have a really awesome schedule, I think, lined up for you guys over the next 2 days. Typically, most business planning clinics, you have one person come in and talk to you. We decided we were going to go big and we were going to have six, right? And we asked people that were really, really experts all over the place, really, but just in particular fields to kind of speak to that one topic they feel really resonated with them the most. And so you're going to have some really great insights from some people that really dive deep into the topics that they're talking about. And so I just wanted to kind of go over the schedule, some of the ground rules, and then I'm going to turn it over to our host, Kimberly and Kitty. Basically, this is a webinar style format, and so you're not going to necessarily be able to turn your video on. We had too many people that signed up, so we had to go big with the webinar. If you do want to unmute yourself, you can kind of raise your hand in the chat box saying that you have a question to ask, and then we can unmute you so that you can ask your question. Or you can feel free to ask the question in the chat box. We'll have people keeping an eye on that so that the instructors won't have to continually be looking at the chat. And we'll let them know that you have a question that you have. So those are two ways that you can ask a question. Is one, either in the chat, say, hey, I have a question, can you unmute me? And we'll unmute you so that you can verbally ask, or you can just type it in the chat box and we'll make sure the instructor gets that as well too. So I want to go over the schedule so that you guys know what to expect today. We're going to go with, Kimber's going to introduce the business planning clinic to us for about 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Then we're going to transition over to Jason Abrams. I can't think of anybody better to go over the models and mindset stuff than Jason, because, I mean, you want to talk about mindset and energy and passion. There's not anybody in Keller Williams I know that brings that more than Jason does. So we're going to go, he'll be on for about 40 minutes between 10:20 to about 11. Then we're going to take a 15-minute break so that you guys can stretch your legs out a little bit. And then we'll come back. We have a sponsor that's going to talk for about 10 minutes, And then we're going to wrap up the day with the amazing Pat Long from the Upper Marlboro Market Center. And she's going to talk about the economic model so that we guys get those dialed in. So that's the day one session for today. That's kind of the ground rules. The only thing I'm going to ask you guys to do is play all in, right? Because ultimately you're here to learn, you're here to grow, and don't just sit back and be passive and watch this stuff. Engage in the activities, engage in the discussion, talk in the chat. If you want to be heard, ask to unmute yourself so that you can ask those questions, because we're going to grow when we play all in. So I'm asking you guys to play all in. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Kimber, and she's going to give you a little bit of a background on what to expect from the business planning clinic today. And
all right. Can you hear me okay? Awesome. I know for many of us, wherever you are, it is pouring, raining, lots of storms. So I've heard some people be like, internet's coming in and out. And we got it. This will be recorded. So if you drop off or you lose part of it, like, we're going to make sure that that you get this and you can come back and revisit it. So as John mentioned, I'm Kimber Minkiti. I'm the regional director for Maryland and DC. And so I have been to many business planning clinics. I know for many of us, this is the time of year. And this year in particular, we are ready to put a bow on 2020 and march into 2021. And this is a chance where we get to take some time and not just be in our business, but really focus on our business. And how do we plan and know what we want to accomplish in 2021? And I can't think of a better opportunity to have these five fabulous instructors, Dr. Pat, who is in her gear, ready to share with us, to actually get the best slices. This is a brand new content in business planning. And big shout out to John Morris, who saw the new curriculum and said, what if we put this all together, had the benefit of this virtual world of really being able to get the best instructors that we have and have each of them deliver a slice of it to you. So it is going to be an action-packed 2 days. So buckle up and get ready. So the first thing, I know we had people even registering this morning. We've got over 600 people that are going to be on really focusing on their business today. So the first piece is your numbers, right? And so if you just got it, maybe you don't have all that yet. I'm going to ask you to like run and grab it. Get your multi-year trend. Understand your numbers. When you jump in the car and you're trying to figure out where you're going, and if you're like me, you get Waze, you get Google Maps, whatever you have, the first thing they ask you is what, right? What is your starting location? You cannot get to where you're going if you don't know where you're starting. So understanding your numbers, what your business has looked like this year, ideally even in the past couple of years, is gonna be a clear indicator to be able to know where you're going. So in the participant guide, you've got your numbers. And I love it, right? We've got a newbie. That's awesome. Because then you're going to think about where do you want to be going, right? What direction are you looking? So the idea is have your numbers. There's a clear one pager there that kind of helps you get started. Please, if you haven't taken a few minutes, like just take a minute now and sort of jot it down so you've got a clear expectation and know where you're going. So that's our big piece. Get your numbers and know where you've been and where you want to go. And then really today, we are going to dive into our five fundamental models, right? So if you've got MREA, many of us, this is what we live and breathe by. It's how we based our businesses, how we've grown them. And so each of our instructors are going to pick apart those models, dive in, and leave you at the end of tomorrow with a business plan for 2021. So the first piece is to actually have it, right? To have it written down, have a clear path to get there. And then that third bucket is to make sure you've got people who can hold you accountable to make sure that you actually implement it, right? So what I love about this business planning clinic, if you are not a passive receiver today of information, you are actually going to be building out your business plan. So when you wrap up tomorrow and you see me back tomorrow afternoon and we are doing our wrap up, you are going to have a plan for your business for 2021. That's our goal for you, right? And so I want to take a minute now in the chat. I want you guys to think about what's your goal for today. What do you want to learn between today and tomorrow? And we're going to just light up the chat. Give me one thing that you want to really make sure that you learn between today and tomorrow. And we're going to be able to share this. We've got our instructors on, so they're going to see the things that you really want to focus on. So let's see them. I love it. I want to get a plan that I can implement in 2021. The how, right? What's the how to really organize the business? I love it. To have an actual plan and not be running all over the place. Antoinette, I am 100% there with you, right? This is how we guide what we're doing. And not just a plan that you do today and it sits on a shelf and you don't revisit it until this time next year. But how do we actually take that plan and implement it in a way that actually is explosive to your business? Oh my God, they're going so fast. I can't even read them all. I love it, right? A blueprint, right? I want to stay on track. A tracking system, 100%. And frankly, like the numbers to track, what are your lead indicators? What are going to be the things that are going to drive your business, the number that you want to wake up every day and focus on? I love it. So just preparing for massive growth, going to E2P. Somebody said 2021 starts now. And that could not be more true. We know that 2021 starts today because the activities of today are already, right? We are in the first quarter of 2021 right now. So the activities we're doing are actually setting yourself up for Q1. Absolutely. Love it. There's so many things. You guys are rocking and rolling, and I love it. Some really great contents. How to turbocharge your Legion. We're going to make sure that our instructors see these, and we're going to hit each of these things as we go through our day today. So take a minute if you haven't, just sort of ground yourself in what you want to make sure you're going to accomplish today to really make this, to get the most out of it. So that's it, right? That's what we're going to do. We've got three things. We're going to complete your business plan. You're going to complete the written part of your business plan. And then we're going to share it and have a path to accountability to make sure that we are accountable and that we hit those targets. So John, that's what I got. We got it. We're going to create our plan. We're going to execute our plan and we're going to rock and roll. So I might have zipped, of course. Sometimes for those that know me as an instructor, I tend to power through my content. So we might have a minute or two before Jason jumps on. Is Jason on yet?
Yeah, Jason's not quite on yet. And so again, feel free to ask your questions in the chat. He'll be popping on in a minute. He's a busy guy, and we usually when we tell him a time frame, he comes right on the time as far as that goes. So he should be here pretty shortly. If you haven't
had a chance. We'll do some housekeeping, John, just so that people know. We are, as John mentioned, if you jumped on a couple minutes late, I keep seeing that ticker. We're already close to 500 participants. So we are in webinar mode. So if you're trying to figure out, I can't mute myself, like, where's my video? Logistically, you're all in participant mode, and what you see on the boxes on the screen, we are in panelist mode. And this is interactive. I know we all want as much interaction as possible. And so we're going to bring people off and on from participant to panelist. So if you want to actually jump into panelists, there's a way you're going to see, right, raise hand. We can get your hand raised. We can bring you on almost like onto the stage with us. And then you can participate, ask questions. So we'll build that in for each of our facilitators so that you can come in. And then when you're in this mode, you just have to do the drop down. I see a lot of you are just doing your comments to us, just to the panelists. So all you have to do in the two section is drop down all panelists and click to all panelists and attendees. That allows everybody else, because so many of you are giving a lot of really great feedback on your goals, but they're only being seen by the six of us that are currently panelists. So just make sure you click that drop down and then we'll all be able to see your comments. There you go, Glenn got it. So I see it, people are already updating. So we're seeing lots more panelists and attendees, so you can all see the comments.
Yeah. And then again, just make sure that you're asking your questions in the comment box. It looks like Jason hopped on, Lori. So if you want to make Jason the co-host there, I think that everybody's ready to get fired up.
And if you have not heard from Jason Abrams, you are in for a treat. Jason is our VP of industry for all of KWRI, has been, I think, in every role, team leader, OP, mega agent celebrity, right? And so I think I couldn't think of a better person to sort of kick this off with us around mindset and models. And then he's going to be followed up by the phenomenal Pat Long, who teaches this whole course. I mean, she could do the whole thing, and she's going to close us out today. So you are in for a fabulous day, and then Brandon Green's going to kick us off tomorrow with John and Seth Daly.
Awesome. I'm excited. All right, cool. Jason, you here?
Yeah, I'm here. Hello, everybody from Austin. This is awesome. Thank you so much for having me. Couple of things. Number one, thank you for being here. The investment that you're making in yourself, that is probably the greatest gift that you can give. And you're thinking, well, wait a second. Rolex would have been nice. Ferrari would have been good. That yacht that I've been kind of, that would have been. Yes, those things, they're all secondary gifts, though. This is to say that in order to be able to give them to yourself on a regular basis, you are going to have some systems and models in your life. Because here's the thing, you might luck into some of it, but you certainly won't earn all of it unless you come correct with systems, models, and planning. So That's where we are headed. It is a bold journey, and we're going to go together. Keep in mind, you got 32 regions throughout America and Canada, and this is the one that I'm doing today in regards to goal setting. And you're thinking, well, what does that mean? Does that must mean you're doing one tomorrow? I'm not. Y'all, I don't think that every one of our regions is having events like this. And that's one of the reasons why yours is one of the fastest growing and most profitable ones that we have. Literally, these sort of investments that your leadership makes into you on a daily basis, that is the gift. Let me give you a quote from the book Giftology. If you haven't read it, I don't know that you need to, because I'm going to give you the best part of it right now. It says, gift giving and those little touches commemorate not just certain events, but people, places, and things that are important to us. Listen to this. In essence, they become the symbol of the value that you place on the relationship. Y'all, if you weren't 100% sure what value your region places on this relationship, y'all better be clear now. It's a tremendous amount of value, because Keller Williams knows that the currency of residential real estate is relationships. This is the key to all of it. So that's the lead in. Number two, I am watching live in the chat log. This is a dialogue, not a monologue. Keep in mind, we're all just making this up as we go. So y'all can ask any question you want. We want to make this interactive. Feel free to ask them and we will get into them. Now, let's get into models and mindset, John. Here's the thing. Everybody simply waking up each day is going to have some natural level of achievement. And some of you achieve at a really high, amazing level, just getting out of bed in the morning and being yourself. By the way, I'm one of those people. I get up, and in this profession, I achieve relatively high with no systems and models. Keep in mind, I'm also unemployable anywhere else, and I'd be fired within a day of being there for the most part. This is the only place where they actually let people like you and I actually be us. But we know that we will hit this level and we will stay there. This is to say that when you talk to people who are top producers at other companies and they say, I've been a top producer for the last 8 years, I've done blank in production the whole time. And you're like, well, why haven't you been consistently moving up? And the truth is because they continue to operate entrepreneurially. These are not new ideas. What we know, though, is that when you build on models, you have stable foundation. See, this is the key. Stable foundation allows you to have a duplicatable and reliable outcome. See, when you build things on creativity, or if you build things on simply being entrepreneurial in your pursuits, those are great ways to do it. And a lot of us, let's be real, we got into residential real estate to embrace our creative sides. But here's the thing. The creative side is the plus to the model. Let me give you a great example of this. So I know y'all are really high fashion in the DC, Maryland area. I get it. I used to live in Bethesda. I had a pair of red bottoms also. And if you weren't paying $2,000 for a pair of shoes, you're just not in style. But here's the thing. Christian didn't look up and create the high heel. The model was the shoe. He then just got creative and painted the bottom red. That's all he did. And in doing so, the shoe went from a $50 shoe, because y'all ladies, you know they hurt your feet. I don't care what you say. But they became a $2,000 shoe. And all of a sudden, everybody is wearing them. And then he had a new model, which was, if I paint the bottom red, then I'm good to go. And you know what? People started wearing them. And what happened next? He then realized that if you wore them, the paint chipped off of them. Ladies, don't even tell me the first night out you weren't disappointed when you got home and realized all the paint was gone. And so what did he do? He got creative and he came up with a clear piece of plastic that he sold for $59. So good. That goes on the bottom of the shoe to protect the red paint. That's all I'm saying. And if you, John, if you go to the next slide, you're going to see exactly what I mean, because this is how this goes, right? You go from improved models, then you have a breakthrough. That breakthrough is driven by creativity. Then you're going to have some form of, you're just going to be there. Before they came up with the plastic covering, what would happen? You'd wear them and then 3 weeks later, they wouldn't be cool anymore. And I know what happened. I saw it firsthand. You guys were there with red nail polish trying to bring them back to life. I get it. No judgment. Then creativity strikes again, though, when he gets the plastic on him. And then there you go. And now he has this breakthrough. What happened next? You guys remember? Originally, it was just ladies' shoes. Then what happens? The next breakthrough comes and he says, we got to do men's shoes too. And then they started doing sneakers. And before you got it, this thing just went. That's how everything cool happens. That's it. If you take, and by the way, there's so much gold that you guys are going to be getting, but if you take nothing else out of this, understand, nothing starts with creativity. Everything starts with real proven models. Then your creativity comes out once those models start to plateau. So if your focusing question that every day you wake up is, what could I create that no one's ever seen before by which to stay in touch with my sphere of influence? I'm not saying that's the wrong question to ask. I'm saying that's the wrong order by which to ask it. The first question should be, what are the greatest sphere of influence touches that are happening nationwide with consumers that look like my data bank? That's the question. Then you go get it, and then you're all over it, and then you start doing that thing, and then you see an increase, and then you say, well, this is awesome. But then you're going to start to see that this increase starts to top out, and then you look up, and that's when you ask the question, how do I 10x this? How do I paint the bottom of this red? Friends, write it down. How do I paint the bottom of this red? I have it written on my wall, and I ask that question all the time. Cool. By the way, keep in mind that the vast majority of people that are in business today won't do any sort of business planning for next year. They'll simply skip that part. And then they'll hope that whatever happens is actually going to happen. And when I say they'll hope that, it's truly hope. Because with no plan, there can be no reliable outcome. And isn't that what you and I are all striving for anyway? Like, isn't that the deal? I read this one all the time and everyone's bored with it, but I'm gonna keep reading it because I think that this quote from the Wealthy Gardener literally summarizes the quest that you and I are on every single day. Because here's the deal. Many things in life are more important than money. But overcoming the money problem allows us to focus on these important things. Without money and time, we yield little power over life. Think about that for a second. Think about that. Then it goes on to say, look, when faced with a problem that money can solve, and we have the money to solve it, then we face a trivial problem. But lacking this money, the smallest of life's problems can become the worst of life's problems. Said differently, if you don't know how you're going to make your Tahoe payment next month, everything else that's going wrong in life can't really be solved because y'all spend so much time just trying to solve those. Now, a lot of y'all are top producers, and so those problems are solved. And so you do the next thing, which is you sit around and you try to figure out how much profit you want out of your business. Let me say this to you differently. You're asking the question, how much compensation do I deserve for the activities that I'm taking? That's what you're asking. And I found a great definition of compensation that I want to read to you. You ready for this? And you're saying, wait a minute. Jason was supposed to talk about models and mindset. Here's the thing. We could talk about models until we're blue in the face. As a matter of fact, Keller Williams has been doing that for the last 35 years. But you know what? Y'all don't care about the word models. I truly believe you don't care at all. I think what you care about is how do these models impact your life? You're asking the question right now, why should I care about this? And I'll tell you why you should care about it. Because compensation is something that we get for something that we give. That's step number one. Compensation is repayment for a contribution that you make that is needed and useful. And we must never forget that our income reflects, number one, the need for our service. Write it down. Number one, the need for our service. Number two, how well we perform it. Number three, the difficulty in replacing us. And number four, and in this case, most important, how many people we get to serve. You see, that's the name in the game. Whether you're a team leader or you're a real estate agent, understand your compensation is in direct proportion to the number of lives that you get to change. Trina, compensation is something we get for something we give. It's repayment for a contribution that is needed and useful. And we must never forget that our income reflects, number one, the need for our service. Number two, how well we perform it. Number three, the difficulty in replacing us. And number four, how many people we get to serve. And so when we start going through this and we take this quote from The Wealthy Gardener, by the way, Chetrel, that'll give you both of those quotes. That's the basis by which we talk about all the models and systems that we're going to set up. That's why I'm going first. That's the only reason I'm first, is because we have to set table stakes for this. If we don't, then it becomes busy work. Like when I tell you in a minute, hey, what we're gonna do is learn how to fill out a 411, and you look up and say, I don't need a document that tells me what to do each day. I'm just gonna use the force and hope for the best. To me, what you're saying is I'm not really serious about the compensation I'm gonna get. That's how I'm hearing it differently. That's a real problem for me. The way that I came to this conclusion, by the way, that y'all don't care about models and systems until you understand why it matters in your life, was out of the book called Simply Said by Jay Sullivan. And here's what he says. He says, newsflash, your audience doesn't care about you. Nothing personal, but they don't. In fact, they don't really care about your content either. They care about how your content impacts them, which is entirely different than your content itself. My gosh, when I read that, my head exploded all over my desk. And I, you know why? Because I was thinking about it. I spent 21 years listing and selling real estate. And every time I would go into somebody's house, they didn't care how many homes I sold that year. They didn't care how many units I was pushing. They didn't care what marketing plan I made. They didn't care at all about any of those things. They didn't care if my face was on a billboard. They didn't care that I was number one in my time slot on HGTV, 1 a.m. to 2 a.m., number one in my time slot. They didn't care about any of that. What they cared was I the best person to shepherd them through this next stage of their life? They cared what difference did it make in my world that being number one made in their lives. And so you're watching all of this today with the exact same prism. You're saying, why does this matter to me? And here's the only reason it matters. Because we know that we build businesses to have big lives. We know that we do these things for money. Let's just be honest about it. There's a million different reasons why you're at KW. All of them, by the way, are valid. But there's one reason that all of us got into residential real estate. It's one connected reason. And you're gonna say, wait a minute, no, it isn't, Jason. I got into it because I loved creativity and I wanted to have new people around me and I wanted to be my own boss. And there's a million different reasons. No, there isn't. Those are all subcategories of one reason. We wanted to yield more control over our lives, period. Whether you wanted to have that control by not having a direct report, which just so you know, 67% of the American populace, when they are asked, say that they would rather have a new boss than a pay raise. 67%, that's from the book, Why Do So Many Incompetent Men Become Leaders and How to Solve It. That's on page one, and that's what it says, 67%. That's amazing to me. Maybe that's one of the reasons you got into this. Maybe you wanted to be making more money. Maybe you wanted to be the one in control of when you were gonna get a raise. Maybe you were the one that wanted to be in control of your time so that when you said, I'm gonna make my family first, you got to mean it. All of those are under the subtitle, more control over my life. Without money and time, we yield little control over life. And y'all run around busy as can be. I know, I'm watching it in command in real time. I'm watching you put in opportunities. I'm watching you load contacts. I'm watching you run campaigns. But let me just be the spoiler and tell you that busyness doesn't mean business. I'm not saying those aren't the right activities to take. I am saying in absence of actually making a plan and then backing into that plan using the language of business, which is math, y'all don't know whether the right actions to take. And so we just do them. And what happens is we get really busy. But you know what? Busyness doesn't mean business. And here's the next universal truth. We don't usually stay busy all year. We got a new year coming up. Have any of you guys ever joined a gym in January? Me too. Now, most of you are smart enough to quit in March. Not me. I like to pay for it all year because the paying part makes me feel better about myself. That's just me. But why does it happen that we join a gym in January and then we're out by February or March? It's not because we don't want to look better. It's not because we don't want to feel better. Those things are true, but it's because as people, we will run from pain much faster than we will run towards pleasure. That's just a fact, and y'all ain't gonna get past it. There's no way to get around it. And so when we sit down and we ask the questions, how do I bring more wealth into my life? How do I bring more abundance into my life? How do I adopt models that bring more passion, more joy into my life? And then I know full well that by January 9th, you're going to abandon the entire thing. How do I sleep at night? Is that the question you're asking yourselves? How do I still manage to get up on the 10th and come back to this building? I'll tell you why. Because here's what I know as a fact. Every year, there's a percentage of people that are willing to do something new. And every year, the vast majority of that group fails. But there's a group of people within that group that succeed. You see, some of you are sitting here today and you're actually saying, I am tired of starting over. Then guess what? Stop giving up. That's when you have to start over. And I'm so tired of hearing people telling me, I am so tired of having to reimagine. I am so tired of having to start over. Then stop quitting all the time. That's all this course is. The 411, let's do this because I can see all your videos. Everybody just hold up your 411s if you have it with you. Just hold them up. By the way, I can see them. Just hold them up just so I can see that you got them. Okay, cool. Here's the thing. I don't see a ton of them being held up. So let's just play this game. I'm willing to bet that the vast majority of you don't have it, which to me is this amazingly freeing idea, which is you must have found some other way to make sure that your annual goals tie to your monthly goals, which then tie back to your weekly goals, ensuring that you actually get the things that you want. Why didn't you just say that to begin with? Because you don't. You're lying. You don't have it. You don't. And it's okay, but what's not okay is to pretend that you do. This is to say that if you actually lined up all the people that are counting on you to hit your financial goal this year, you'd have a really long list of people, and I'm willing to bet you would actually care about them. And someone saying, I've never seen this document. You know what? Martin, I hear you. This is a document that doesn't live and breathe the way that I think it should, but here's the experience that I had. I made it like 18 years at KW without filling mine in all the time. And I'm going to talk to you about how to fill this in. But then I came to KWRI. And every single Friday, I had to turn mine in to Gary. And he was serious about it. And then he pulled out his, and he was really serious about it. And then I realized that some of the tools that I had thought were really built for somebody else were actually built for me. That there was a difference between the people that were in my life that were having big success and everybody else. And it was what my brain was telling me. Hey, John, take this off for a second. We're coming back to this in a minute. My brain had been telling me, I don't need tools. My brain was telling me, I don't need a model and system. You see, my brain was saying, Jason, you don't need models. But I want to just tell you guys, those of you that are saying that, you're using models all the time, constantly. Listen to this quote from, this is so good, from the Million Dollar Habits. Listen to this. If belief cannot be willed, how does one acquire it? It's a fair question, by the way. And you can take out the word belief and you can put anything you want in there. And it says the same way he or she achieves an understanding of the way the world works. I'm about to tell you the system and model that you've been using your entire life by which to understand everything around you. And when I tell it to you, you're going to have what I hope is an insight. This is to say that these insights are already inside of you. You're not going to hear in a minute anything you haven't known your entire life. My hope is that you hear it differently. Listen to this. They achieve this by understanding the way the world works, which is only done through the attainment of knowledge and wisdom. The greater your knowledge and wisdom, the more confident you are in your beliefs. That's a universal truth. Everybody gets that. By knowledge, I'm referring to the acquisition of specific information. By wisdom, I'm referring to insight or common sense. Friends, you're here today to get some new knowledge. The reality of it is this wisdom, I believe we were all born with a soul that's filled with all the things that we're actually going to need in this life. And everybody that comes into your life, they simply get to either give you a key to unlock a piece of it, or they're not going to give you any keys. And you know the difference between those people in your life. The people who are not giving you any keys, you should be running from as fast as your legs can carry you. It's okay to outgrow some relationships. Do it today. But the people that have been giving you these keys, those are the ones that you need to open your soul and your heart up to, because they're going to help you find all these insights. So this idea that you don't need models and systems, guys, that's absurd. It's absolutely absurd. It's just that you haven't found the key to your natural wisdom that tells you that models and systems actually are the secret to everything, and you've been using them. Some of you are going to say, models, they limit my freedom. As soon as I try to put a structure in place, I have to live that way. Friends, models and systems are the things that unlock true freedom. Let me just ask you the question. If you had $10 million in the bank right now, do you think you'd feel more free? Now, the vast majority of you are going to say yes, but a couple of you already know the secret that it doesn't matter how much money you have. You truly won't know freedom until you're comfortable with yourself. That will come, I promise. All I'm saying is we all got together in residential real estate to make more money. And because of that, we need to bring models and systems into our income generating activities such that we can go solve the rest of the problems of life. You're going to say, hey, models are just opinions. Everything I'm hearing Abrams talk about today is his opinion. The reason I'm reading and quoting all these books is to get you past that. If y'all think we made this up on the Uber ride in today, then you're fooling yourself. And the only reason you would be willing to cling to that idea is to be absolved from having to actually hear and then make changes. I get that. That would probably feel safer to me too. That's not going to work though. Because when you speak in universal truth, nobody can debate it. There are just some things that are real. There are some things that just are. And there's some of you that are saying, models aren't going to work for me. Friends, the definition of the word model means it will work for you. The question isn't whether the model will work for you. The question is, will you work with the model? That's it. That's the only question. And do you know why? It's because models are based on proven ideas. When Gary and Jay and Kimber and John and Pat and Kim, when they get into a room to draft models, which they do all the time, what no one's allowed to say is, I think this will work. I'm hoping this model, that's just not how they do it. You realize, think about the millionaire real estate agent book that they wrote. Jay interviewed 125 millionaires over a 2-year period just to be able to write the book. That means he's not guessing, period. Or you're going to say, I don't need change. I'm getting the results I want. By the way, if you're getting the results you want, I would urge you to up yours. Like Gary Keller says that to me all the time, then up the things that you want because you deserve to have a hell of a lot more of it. There's no scenario where what you're getting today should be what you settle for forever. Now, some of you might say, I'm getting what I want out of certain parts of my life. Awesome. But then don't tell me there aren't other parts of your life that can be expanded. The secret to life, as Gary teaches us, is that you want to know everything, but there's only so much to know. And you want to help everybody, but there's only so many resources to help. And you want to do everything, but there's too much to do. So if you somehow have surfed to the end of the internet that is life and you feel completely fulfilled, then you need to get with someone who thinks a little bit bigger. Because this gift that we have, this ultimate gift that we have, is only truly unlocked when we bring in the knowledge by which to find our own wisdom. That's, I'm going to keep coming back to it, because everything you're going to hear today, you already know. My only job, I have one job. My only job here today in the 45 minutes that I have is to get you to be willing to hear these things differently, because there's no new content here. That's the dirty secret. The idea that what you do tomorrow, you're going to have to do the next day and the next day and the next day. And that on the other side of boredom will actually lead to success. And that the vast majority of people will be unwilling to be bored or successful are universal truths that as humans, we must live with. Look up at this country right now and realize that half of them, half of the people here make less than $35,000 a year. Get real clear on it. Look up right now and realize that the majority of the American populace can't put $2,000 in cash together for an emergency expense. look up right now and realize that we have entire communities that are forgotten, that are economic dead zones, and then look up and ask yourself just how lucky and blessed are the 600 of us who all happen to end up at Keller Williams right now in a region that cares enough to be helping us plan for 2021. And then look up and realize that the greatest gifts we have are not behind us, but in front of us. And ask the question, what am I going to do to change my family's life? What am I going to do to change mine? And how am I going to change the people around me? That would be the question to ask. We know that big thinking leads to big goals. That's why I said up yours. So any goal you have, whether it's for love, for money, for power, up them. You deserve it. Gordon Gekko said it in the movie Wall Street. He said, greed, ladies and gentlemen, for lack of a better word, is good. Greed's right. Greed works. Greed for money, greed for love, greed for power. And greed, ladies and gentlemen, will not only save Teldar Paper, but this malfunctioning company that we call the U.S. economy. Now, that was his quote. I'm going to augment it just a touch, because I'm going to tell you that if you take out the word greed and you just put in the word love, you're going to be in Keller Williams culture every step of the way. You should want more love in your life. You should want more power in your life. You should want more wealth in your life. And damn it, you should insist that it shows up. Because if it actually was lined up that way, the entire universe would work together to make sure you have it. That's the secret. That's the law of attraction that Gary and Diana and Josh have been telling us forever. You see, the problem with the law of attraction, the problem with the idea of models, the problem with all of these books is that your brain right now is hardwired to try to find holes in all of it. You don't want to believe that it can simply be as easy as setting an intention and then being unwilling to not accomplish it. You don't want to. And you know why you don't want to? It's not your fault. It's human nature. We learned about it in the book, The Untethered Soul. You see, here's what he says. He says that you, whether you realize it or not, you have a roommate that's with you all the time, but that roommate is just you. And to prove it, let's play this game. Everybody right now, silent your mind, take a deep breath. By the way, you're not too cool for this. Can you just play along and just pretend you like me? Okay, take a deep breath. Now I want you to yell the word hello in your mind. Think about what you just did. Not, I guarantee you, you actually just somehow yelled in your mind without saying anything out loud. Who is that voice that is yelling at you? You see, that voice is exactly you, but here's what you're asking. Why am I doing this? I have more important things to do. This is a waste of time. There's nobody here but me. What's this all about? Right on cue, there is your roommate. You may have a clear intention to be quiet inside your mind, but your roommate won't cooperate. Friends, what if I told you that your roommate was an absolute crazy person? I could prove it. You ever have a song stuck in your head and it just won't go away? That's literally your crazy roommate singing to you. You wouldn't be friends with anybody like that who just broke into spontaneous song at all hours. How about when you're laying in bed and you want to go to sleep and you keep telling yourself, I'm so tired, but I can't sleep. What kind of crazy person does that? All of us do. We all do. And so as you go through this, these things are going to creep into your mind. And what I want you to be willing to do is yell the word hello again and stop all of the chatter and then realize it's just you. You see, we're born with these three things, mind, consciousness, and thought. The mind is this thing that we have that allows us to take in all of the majesty that is life. Our consciousness forces us to actually then take it and then relay it into how it impacts our lives. And most important, our thoughts are simply us trying to make sense of those things. So if you really want to be sitting right in the center of mental health, the key is to realize it's you doing all the thinking. This idea should be being talked about your whole life, but it isn't. It's the same reason why we have an epidemic of young ladies who end up thinking that their bodies aren't perfect, even though every one of them are. It's the same reason that we have a group of men who might look up and not feel masculine enough, although every one of them are exactly who they should be. This idea that our thoughts somehow betray us isn't a guess. It's a guarantee. Because there's 17 billion neurons running around in the part of your mind that's supposed to be creating doubt about everything that you're seeing today. And it's working on absolute overdrive. And any time for the rest of the day that you decide that this isn't for you, or you don't deserve to have more wealth, or you don't deserve to have a bigger life, I want you to yell the word hello in your mind and then come back and listen to John, Kimber, Kim, and Pat, and everybody else, and realize that all of this is your birthright. All yours already. All of the wisdom is there. All we're doing is giving you knowledge in the form of keys to unlock it. You have the keys to the kingdom. All right, you guys, I got a very limited amount of time. I have 30 seconds left. Here's what I want you to know when I leave. The most important thing at Keller Williams is for you all to know that you're the best part of this company. Josh and Gary are really clear on this, and so am I. The currency of Keller Williams is relationships, and our most important one is your relationship with yourself. Use today as the gift that it is, and have an awesome business planning.
Whoa, thank you so much, Jason. Really appreciate you.
Yeah. Never short on energy.
Really good, great way, I think, to start out the day. And I think most of the people, you know what, Jason took some time out of his busy day. I would like everybody in the chat log just to say thank you and how much you appreciate Jason, because this was really a special thing that you guys got to hear this morning. And I think we should show Jason some love.
I love it. It's like booming. I love seeing, and this is recorded, so I feel like we all kind of need that like jolt of a mindset. So you'll be able to go back and get it.
All right, so we are a little bit ahead of schedule. There's some things that I want to share on the screen here really quick, and just so that we can kind of set you up for the rest of the day. And then I want to, Kimber, let's do some ahas from that session a little bit as well, too. But there's a couple things that I just wanted to go over that Jason, he kind of goes off script sometimes. And so there was a couple things on the slides that he didn't get to. So I just want to make sure that we kind of go over those. You know, what we're really going to dive into today is the foundational models in the MREA, which again is listings, leverage, and leads. The slide, actually, they messed up a little bit. I'm looking at this for the first time here. There should be leads on there as well, too, right? And then I just want to kind of go over this again. The economic model, which Pat's going to go over next, is really the to achieve the amount of net income you desire. What's left over for you? Right. And then as we get into the next thing, the lead generation model, which I'll be going over tomorrow, in order to make the money that you want to make, how many leads do you need to get in order to make the income that you want to make? And then Brandon's going to go over the budget model, and he's going to talk about, you know, hey, where does your money go so that you know what you're spending on? Because who cares if you make, you know, $1 million a year if you spend the $950 to make that $1 million a year, right? And then Seth tomorrow is going to go over, hey, when are you, should you look at making that first hire? I know a lot of people are starting to look at, hey, do we want to start building out some teams, or do I want to build out a team, or when should I hire this person? Seth's going to talk to us about, you know, being able to do that. And, you know, when maybe should you look at expanding so that you can systematize your business? You're crushing it in your local market center. Should I be looking to go to some other spots as well, too? So that's kind of what we're going to go over for the rest of the time here. And what I'd like to kind of end this session out before we kind of head to break, we got about 10 minutes and maybe we'll go to break a little bit early. But what were some ahas that we got from this session with Jason so far? And feel free to respond into the chat. Feel free to ask if you could, you know, if you want to verbalize it, you know, make sure that you verbalize it as well too. But what were some ahas that you guys got from this? Busyness doesn't mean business. Yeah, I like that. So many great books. That's a lot of ahas too. I gotta like that one, the voice in my head. Not an aha, but I always love the book references. Our habits matter, and believe in the self, deserve to have wealth. Yeah, you guys do deserve to have wealth. The 411, yeah, a lot of people, like Kimber, I saw a lot of people say they didn't even know what the 411 was, right? Absolutely. Implement and innovate. Stop quitting. That was one of the favorite ones that I had, too, is, you know, you hear people say, well, I got to start over, or I got to reinvent myself, or, hey, I got to do something different. And it's like, well, no, you don't. Just don't quit, right? Models. That was a big one as well, too. A lot of people saying the hello in my head. That was a good one for me. I had never really thought about it like that, but there is a crazy person running around in my head sometimes too. Up yours. Greed is good. Yeah, there's a lot of good ones. So it looks like we've got a lot of people that got a lot out of this.
Hey, John, one thing I want to add too, it kind of goes back to one of the ahas that was there, you know, is the fact that most people quit too soon, right? Whether that be something they're working on with their lead generation, maybe it's a big goal or business plan. If something doesn't work right away, people usually go to greener pastures too soon. And so that's just a reminder for everybody here of just like, make sure you're not quitting too soon and stay consistent with the activities long enough for you to get the return on the investment that you're making.
Yeah, absolutely. And so that when and you see that all the time, sometimes people are literally just steps away from hitting the goal that they want and they quit because they don't see that it's right there. Right, Kim? And I'm sure you see that a lot being a TL. You're dealing with agents that, man, if they just stuck it out for one more day, literally, they would have accomplished a whole lot. Right.
And I saw some people, and this is kind of the exercise as you go through this in that 411. And I love that Jason says, and I've been on the phone with him, and he's like, oh, it's like 7 o'clock on Monday morning. And Gary Keller is like texting him, like, where's your 411? So I think that power of an accountability partner. And if you're looking around and you're like, I don't have one, call your team leader, call your PC, call your assistant team. Like, your leadership team is there to be that support for you. So if you get through all this tomorrow and you're like, man, I just really, like, I need somebody to really help me make sure that I'm accountable to this, then look around. You've got those people in your system that want to be your support in being successful.
Absolutely.
We have a raised hand, Cassandra. I gave you permission to speak if you want to unmute.
Sandra?
If not, we can keep them coming in the chat. I know we're all working on this new format.
Somebody said, is the 411 a book? The 411 is not really a book. That is, should be a handout that you have in the guide that was sent to you. And then you can also get it on KW Connect to be able to fill out as well too. Kim, so you're a TL, you work with this a lot. What's kind of, for the people that don't really know what the 411 is, what do you do with that?
Yeah, so it's basically it's a tool so that you can stay on track to hit your goals every month, right? So as you can see on the 411, it's broken down to your yearly goal, which is your one big goal that you're focused on, and then your monthly goal. What do you have to accomplish each month in order to hit your yearly goal? And then it's broken down into the each week for the month. And so the idea is to put your activities on there that you're focused on for that goal. And let's just say in week one, you don't hit all of the things that you were supposed to hit. Then you can see, what do I need to move over and add on to week two so that you can stay focused on the activity, so at the end of the month, you can hit your goals by staying focused first on the activities.
Awesome. It says, I'm looking at some other ones here. Sherry's talking about, being able to, hey, we need more money and we need more time, right? To get more control. We don't control our lives if we don't have both of those things. So you're going to learn a lot about that today, right? Heather said, we're a level 6 team. This info is great for agents who are trying to make a plan and grow. Is there a section in this seminar that would be beneficial for our volume or team dynamics? Kimber, what would you say to somebody that is on a level 6 team? Is there something for them in this?
I think there's something for this in all of it, right? Because you're going to have your team, like if you're on a part of a big team, you've got a team goal. Inside of that, each agent on the team has their own individual goals, right? That really match what you want to be able to do. And Pat made a great point, just that we're going to take a quick break. And this is the opportunity. I saw some people that were like, I'm a little bit lost. Do I need my participant guide? So if you don't have your participant guide, check your email. Dana sends emails to everybody. You have a participant guide. This is really, particularly as we head into the next section with Pat, you're going to want to have the guide available. So whether like you have it up on your computer, you've got it printed out, use the break to both get your guide so that you can stay on track and follow along. This is where we're actually going to like get into the meat of building out your plan and your numbers. So when we take a break, John will send us off and give you exactly the time frame to get back in front of your computer, but use this window, not just for your bathroom break, but also make sure you're fully ready to go and you've got all your materials. And if you need those, Dana or Lori, what's the best way if for some reason somebody doesn't have the participant guide and wants to grab it?
They can just send a message in the Q&A and we'll go ahead, just send us their email and we'll send it over to them.
Awesome. So if for some reason you did not get the email, even though you're on, so you definitely got the link, drop your email in and we will get it over to you.
Yeah, because I know that some people registered a little bit late, so they might not have gotten the email out with the booklet. And so if that was you, definitely make sure that you, in the Q&A section, put your email address in so that Lori and Dana can get that guide out to you. All right. So
Dana's doing it right now. So drop your thing in and drop it in and we'll definitely get it over to you. And still people are just sending messages to us as panelists. We love seeing all of your messages, but I know, and some of you are sending great resources, but they're only going to us. So you just have to drop down in the chat. There's all panelists or all panelists and attendees. So we've got almost, 600 people on this call, and please make sure you change it in the chat. And then when you're sending out great resources, books, links, it's going out to everybody.
Yeah. And then Nick, you put in there a link to the 411. So if you want to just pull a quick copy off of Connect from that, you have the ability to grab that link and then be able to at least get a copy of that as you're waiting for the guide, if you want to start kind of working on that a little bit too. Samantha says, please refer to pages 2.17 or 3.13 because we don't have page numbers. Okay. Awesome. Anything for the panelists, anything else? It looks like some of the ahas kind of stopped here a little bit. Anything else before we head out to break that you guys want to say or let the crowd know about?
Just that it is in there. 2.15 is the 411. And then Pat will direct you back into the participant guide as she gets started. So how much time for break, John? We have a quick, just a couple minutes, right?
Well, we actually set it up for a little bit longer of a break, so that gives them the ability to go grab some coffee, maybe use the restroom here for a second. So we have it set up for a 15-minute break. Then we have our sponsor talking for about 10 minutes. So we're about 5 minutes ahead of schedule. So we'll just say that we're going to come back at 10 after 11, and then we'll have the sponsor talk. Yeah, then we'll have the sponsor talk for about 10 minutes, and then we'll get Pat on, and then maybe we get you out of here a little bit early. So
awesome. So don't jump off. Just pause. You're muted if you're not a participant. So just you can leave your computer up. Just run, do what you need to do, and we'll see you back here in 15 minutes.
All right.
And pop your email in if you need the workbook. Dana is busy shooting that off to everybody, so we're monitoring that. John, somebody's asking who our sponsor is.
Lori, I think you need to answer that question because I'm not sure who the sponsor is. Lori, you're on mute.
You're muted, Lori.
We should have Jennifer Stevens Long from Cinch on. So I will find her and make her a panelist. Give me a minute.
And Ben asked, if I jump off, can I get back in when I try to access from my phone on the go? Yeah, as long as you have that link, you should be able to get on if you have to listen to it on your phone. And then Million Dollar Habits author, that Todd, I wrote that down here real quick. That was Robert Ringer is the author of that. I love that Lana put in here, don't give up 5 minutes before the miracle happens.
Good question, Pat. Someone's asking because it is a long workbook if you're working from home, and 138 pages is a bit daunting. Pat, are there specific pages you think you want them to have printed, or that would be great for your section coming up next?
I would like for them to have printed 3.1. And let's see. If they print out 3.1 to 3.22, we're good. And that has your 411. I'm super jazzed because you're going to create your 411 and your business plan in the next 2 days. This is just incredible. So I can't wait.
All right.
Are those printout pages, Pat, from the guide or the workbook?
It's from the manual. From the big manual. 3.1 to 3.22. And we will be good to go. You print those out, we will be good to go.
John, Maureen is actually joining us to speak for the sponsor today. Maureen Fleming, I just made her panelist here. Hi, Maureen.
Hey, can you hear me?
Can hear you, yep. Great.
All right, I'm trying to get my camera working.
Yeah, so Amy said that, hey, I've...
Oh, my host has stopped it, it says. Can you start my camera?
Yeah, as long as you named her host or co-host, I think that you can turn the camera on. And then it looks like...
I'm not going to be as cheery as Jason. My goodness, that guy has a lot of energy.
Yeah, no, Jason's got quite a bit.
He's awesome.
Yeah, so Amy asked a question. She said, I've attended the business clinic for the last 2 years, and I'm wondering if the workbook has changed. Could I just use that? It probably changed just a little bit because they've updated the business planning clinic for 2020. So there's probably going to be a few things in there that are a little bit different.
Cool.
And Timothy has a question. A raised hand there. Timothy, I just gave you permission to speak. I don't know if you can unmute.
There we go.
I don't know, is that not working?
Not sure.
Timothy, are you able to click off your mute button and speak?
Yeah, Samantha said we don't have mute or any audio controls. In the webinar format, Samantha, you don't have the ability to just unmute yourself. You have to ask to unmute yourself, and then one of the panelists can let you basically talk.
Same with Brandy. I just gave her the ability to speak as well. I don't know where their mute option is after I give them the ability to speak.
You should be able to just press your space bar, and then that should be able to unmute you. Yeah, that's another thing too, Lori, is that if somebody wants to come on screen and talk, we could make them a panelist so that they can get on, and then we can remove panelists after they ask their question too.
Yeah, I'd like to figure out why this isn't working.
Yeah, it looks like... Looks like Delara had a question too, so I'll click allow to talk. Delara, can you talk?
Yeah, I actually just wanted to help you guys try.
Okay. Well, hey, it works. So we know that you can do it.
It does work. There. Yeah.
It's in the left-hand corner, and it prompts you to unmute yourself.
Okay, cool.
All right, so it's not on our end. At least I know that. Good.
Thank you.
So an anonymous attendee asks, when asking about last year's listing appointments and buyer consults, are you asking us to use the 2019 numbers or our numbers year to date? So what would be the best way to do that, Pat?
So in the pre-work, That's asking you to just work with the numbers that you have so far this year. And when we do the actual business planning, you're going to use your goals for 2021.
Awesome. So hopefully that answers your questions, anonymous attendee. As we are on break a little bit, I'm going to go grab a little bit of coffee myself, so I'll be right back.
On the way, I was crowned a king. Felt the wind underneath my wings. I've been high and I've been low. Played the fool in the star of the show. Gone along for a wild ride. And I can say, looking in your eyes, that it all would have been a waste. But I found you on the way. I found cynicism. On the way, I was given the keys to the city. They were my
I found pessimism, I found skepticism. I've been the corner performer and sung in front of millions. I lost more than a heart can take, but I found you on the way. The one thing that I can say, I
found you, I found you, I found you, I found you, it all would have been a waste, but I found you on the way. Whoa.
Kimber, you're on mute.
All right, there we go. All right, so we're going to jump back in. We've got Maureen with us from SIN. She's going to just share a little bit about the services that they offer, and then we're going to jump right back in with Dr. Pat.
Hi, hi, Maureen. Everybody. How are you?
Great.
So as usual, you know, at Cinch, we were HMS, right? Home Warranty. Cinch is our new name for about a year. This is our 1 year anniversary of our brand new name and our new marketing and everything. So, so as Jason says, you know, people are interested in what affects them, right? So what I'd like to do is to just, you know, talk to you a little bit about that. So, as a partner, we love to support you guys in what you do, right? We love to be part of your systems and your company and the Maryland DC region. So one of the biggest things that affects you as far as warranty goes is how many closings have you done where it's contentious over who's going to do repairs and things like that? And then also how many times have you had somebody who something breaks within the first couple of months, right? After they close. So this really does affect you guys, right? It affects you and it affects your business. It's a risk management tool for you in your business to make sure that your homeowners are covered, right? So my biggest thing for warranty for you guys is, you know, what are you going to do when they call you? And they always do call you and they say, you know, oh, you know, in the summer, my air conditioner broke, right? We've been in the house for 4 days. Or my favorite is, you know, we've been in for 6 days and the hot water heater just leaked all over the entire basement, right? So, you know, repairs do happen, right? Home ownership a lot of times is very new, right? How many times do you deal with people who, you know, are brand new homeowners and they just don't understand the maintenance aspects of it? So, so warranty is actually really good as far as that goes, right? You know, we're there to come out and to, you know, come out and fix it. And if we can't fix it, then we replace it, right? So that's why you need warranty. A couple of things about us since we went with the Cinch and the rebrand. We are 1 year into our 1 year anniversary of our rebrand. So we were Cinch Home, we were HMS Home Warranty for the real estate channel. And we are now in the rebrand for a year. So what we're doing is there were five companies that are now into one company. And what we did was we did new marketing, new branding, a whole new look, a whole new feel to it, right? These are our brochures. I'm sure that they're everywhere in all of your offices, right? And then the other thing that is big on the brochures is we've got on the back panel, we now have my face and my contact information. And Jennifer's also, and Donna's in your different areas, right? So any office, we would have our own special brochures into it. So during COVID, Cinch took 900 people in our call centers, and we moved them to work from home. So we did that within a week. We had all 900 of them working from home. So we kept our call center intact and we just moved everybody home. So they've been home since March. They pushed us out to August and then they pushed us out to January. And then I think soon we're coming up on, they're going to push us back out to maybe June or July. So we're up and running for both of our call centers, our Florida call center and our South Carolina call center. And we are up and running and we're working from home, and things have we've actually done really well. And we've kept everybody in business and keeping things running. So that's been our biggest thing. So since digital, we're 2 years into our digital. So in our digital, we've got the homeowner, the service provider, and the Cinch authorizations department and the claims team that are all on ServiceBench, our new software system. So we've been running that for 2 years. So we get quicker updates, we get quicker parts ordering on the back office, and we get quicker claims closed. So that's actually a great part of it. So our success this summer, summer 2020 has been tough, right? There's been parts delays, manufacturing delays, things like that. Wow, my head is huge now. Thank you. So parts delays, right? And everything. So 80% of our claims start and finish within 2.2 days. So that's, they call us and we get someone dispatched and we get them fixed, right? With 2.2 days. This summer. So that's 80% of our claims. 15% of our claims start to finish within 5 days. And then there's 5% of our claims that are longer than 5 days. And those are due to like replacements of appliances. And that's usually we are ordering the appliance and it just takes longer to get it out to there. And some parts delays. So that's been our big thing. So HMS Cinch, we do 1 million home service requests a year. Right? We're 40 years in the business and we're 40 years in the Mid-Atlantic, which is all of you guys, and then the Midwest. So most of our business is in the Mid-Atlantic and the Midwest. So we run close to 1 million home service claims a year in your area. So please call me or Jennifer or Donna if you've got any kind of a claims issue. We've got our own claims team that we work with. So what we do is we send to our claims team and they work with the same service providers in our area. They make sure that your homeowners have one point of contact in the claims process. And that actually makes life so much easier because it's just one person to talk to when they're having a claims issue. They can hold their hand and walk them through the whole thing. So that's actually really, really helpful. So if you have a claims issue that you guys have trouble with, you know, please just let either me or Donna or Jennifer know, whichever one of the counties you guys are in. And we can put them into our claims team and then we can actually control it. We get updates on things, everything that they want to do. So as far as claims go, appliances and systems break. Many of your homeowners, your new homeowners, they've just bought a house. They don't have $500 or more to actually repair or replace an appliance, right? A lot of this summer, we saw a lot of dishwasher claims. We saw a lot of air conditioning claims, of course, right, for the summer. And then a lot of refrigerator claims, right? Refrigerators are close to $2,000 now. So, you know, warranties are running, our least expensive warranty runs around $500, which actually really good coverage. And then our most expensive is probably $650 on a single family home for the premier version. So we're between like $500 and $650 for most of our warranties. So for that kind of money, if you've got a single appliance that is, it's totally worth doing a warranty for it. So how HMS Cinch brings value to you guys in the Keller Williams brokerage and then in the Maryland DC region specifically. We want to do more events like this one that we do. We love to participate and be a sponsor for an event like this, an event where you are growing your business, right? Where we're helping you to grow your business. This is how we like to participate with you guys. This is kind of our sweet spot as far as, you know, we want to bring value to you and bring value to your business. So, we just want you guys to be part of our, you know, we just appreciate when you are at these events, if you would just, you know, consider us when you're doing a listing appointment, or you've got a buyer that's closing, if you would just put us, you know, put a warranty on for us, that would be awesome, right? Protect you, protect your homeowners, and then help us grow our businesses too. We'd like to thank you from each of us, from me, Donna, and Jennifer. You can find us on the Cinch Home Services website. We're on the brochures that I showed you. We're in your offices. So each of us have a Facebook account, a LinkedIn account. A lot of us are on your internal Facebook groups, right? So we're in there. If you have a question and say, hey, how, you know, who's our HMS? Who's our Cinch person? How do I find them? We respond, or one of your agents in your offices can respond. So have a great 2-day business planning event. We're really happy to be part of it with you guys. Have a successful 2021. Keep in mind, appliances and systems do break, and that we are part of your risk management tool. Be well, stay safe, and thanks a lot for everything.
Thank you so much, Maureen, for sharing that with us. Any questions anybody has before Maureen pops off about Cinch? Samantha says she's going to need to get some brochures, so.
Okay. Just let us know what office, and we will have them sent out.
Maureen, will you share all of your contact information in the chat? And if you'll just take a look at the chat, I think people had been asking some questions while you were talking.
Oh, okay.
And I think feel free to answer them.
Answering some of them too.
Sure. The other thing that we can do is we also have, we have an e-card that I can do. And from the e-card, you can get our brochure. You can contact any one of us. So it's a specific e-card to each one of us, but you can actually get to our website. You can enroll a warranty, it's a mobile app for you. So you can do a lot of things from our e-card. So we can put that in the chat too for each of us. I'm trying to look at some of the questions. Jennifer put hers in. Are there age restrictions? Is that what I'm looking at?
I think, Maureen, if you could just maybe respond in the chat, and that way, because I want to make sure we stay on schedule. Is that okay?
Sure.
Awesome.
Perfect.
We'll email everyone their contact info as well.
All right. Well, thank you. Thanks for everything.
Thank you.
Thank you. So we got a couple questions before we get jump back into it real quick. We want to make sure that we answer there. Samantha asks, hey, if we're newer and we're not really sure what realistic numbers to use for a business plan, what should we do? Pat, how would you answer that?
Now, that's a great question. And what you're going to do is you're going to start thinking about what you want your profit to be for 2021, because we're going to start with profit first. So start thinking about what profit do you want to get out of your business in 2021? And that's the number that we'll start with.
Awesome. And then a couple other ones before we jump in and Pat takes it away is Parissa asks, for number of people in database, I have a total of 2297, that is agent, affiliate, and clients, but I only have communication and touch base with 934 on a biweekly basis. And out of that, 470 of them are my actual Mets. What number should I write in for the number of contacts?
That's going to be a lead generation question that you'll get to answer tomorrow.
Awesome. So you're going to leave that one for me.
I would
basically say, you know, you're not going to be, it's who you're going to be doing business with, Parissa. So in other words, if you have agents in there that aren't going to turn into an actual buyer or seller for you, that's going to give you a little bit of unrealistic numbers. So I would basically say it's going to be, for at least for the numbers for the business planning, you're going to want to probably put in the number of people that potentially could become clients, not people that aren't going to necessarily be clients. If that makes sense. And then last question, and then we'll get started again. Anonymous attendee said, to mirror Samantha's question, if you are new to a market area and don't have a sphere of influence, how do you start building it by cold calling? Seriously, I know no one. Right. And so we'll get into that tomorrow with the lead generation aspect of it. So we can jump into the economics. But I'll make sure that I write that one down, and I'll address one of those things first when I get to my section tomorrow. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Pat Long, amazing superstar team leader from the Upper Marlboro office in Maryland here. And so, Pat, take it away.
All right, I am getting ready to share my screen. I have, oh, I may be able to do this by myself. Hey, look at me.
Hey.
All right, so we're gonna need to go back one though. I have my production guy here. Say hi, Emmerich. All right, here we go. All right, so for those of you who don't know me, I'm Pat Long. I am the broker owner of Keller Williams Preferred Properties in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. I also have the honor of being a KWRI, that's Keller Williams Realty International, Hall of Fame team leader. So today I have the pleasure of coming to you to walk you through the creation of your economic model. So I'm super excited about that. And Emmerich, you gotta move your arm because you're in my notes. Okay. All right, so we're gonna walk through the creation of your economic model. And with that being said, I always teach the business planning clinic. I always do it this way with my lab coat and my stethoscope. And just in case I have to go and come and revive any of you, because we're getting ready to do some math, okay? Now, one of my core values is fun. And so that's what I intend to do with you today, is we're gonna have some fun while we go through the economic model. Plus, Halloween is just a couple of days away. So if I'm gonna have to teach math, it's way more fun doing it with a stethoscope around my neck. All right, so now let me tell you why I am so excited about this economic model. The economic model is the first fundamental model, and it actually encapsulates all of the other models. So you're going to get a taste of each one of the models that you'll be learning more about tomorrow. And what I really love about the 2020 business planning workshop is that at the end of this, you will have your 411 and your business plan with all of the fundamental models for your business in 2021. It can't get any better than that. All right, so are you guys ready? Are you ready for a little math? Oh. As an MDRE, that's what I am today. So for the next 90 minutes, I am no longer Pat Long the broker. I am Dr. Long, MDRE. That's Doctor of Real Estate. And I've got to warn you, as an MDRE, I've got to warn you that when we dive deep into this economic model, it's going to look like a lot of math. And I'm gonna ask you not to push away from it, okay? It's gonna be all right, because once you learn the math, which we're gonna learn today, you will have a career worth owning. Nope, you'll have a career worth having, a business worth owning, and life worth living, experiences worth giving, and legacies worth leaving. So we're gonna go ahead and get started on this economic model. Now, before you have an opportunity to create your economic model, we're gonna take a look at the economic model for a millionaire real estate agent team that is netting $1 million. So it's netting $1 million. Now, for those of you who have downloaded the manual, it's all pre-filled in on page 3.1. So you'll see it all pre-filled in. What we're gonna do though, is we're gonna take this, oh, don't click yet. We're gonna take this a step by step. And so everybody, what I want you to do right now is I want you to get out your calculator, all right? So everybody get out your calculator and we're gonna take this step by step. So step number